What's up, guys and girls? Anna here from Behringer. I was recently looking into mics. I needed to record some vocals and an acoustic guitar. And then I thought, which one do I need? And I took all of them! So today I just want to clarify some of those technical words related to mics. Let's start. Number one, condenser or dynamic. So in front of me I have a condenser microphone, the Behringer SB78A, and a dynamic microphone, the Behringer SL84C. So they're pretty similar on the outside, no? But not on the inside. So let's take a look at the capsules. You can see a dynamic microphone has three main components: the diaphragm, the voice coil, and a magnet. Condenser mic's main components are the diaphragm, the backplate, and the diaphragm case that holds everything together. The voice coil is in a magnet field generated by this permanently charged magnet. What happens then is that the audio signal is converted into an electric signal. For most of condenser mics, you need an external power source to generate an electrical field in the capsule. This required power is known as 48 volt phantom power. Here, the sound wave hits the diaphragm that moves back and forth from the backplate, and the acoustic signal turns into electric signal. Dynamic mics handle loud noise better and reject background noise very well. They are the preferred mics for live use. Condenser mics are far more sensitive, allowing you to generally capture a higher dynamic range. They're mostly recommended for use within treated recording environments. Number two, pickup patterns. It refers to the sensitivity of the mic in regards of sound angle and direction. Let's quickly go through the most common ones and do some mic tests. We have the omnidirectional pattern. It means that the mic records audio from every direction. Let's test so the Bigfoot here, which has different patterns, and one of them is the omnidirectional. So just let me connected. Omnidirectional should pick up the sound from all directions. All directions, yeah. Yeah, so it is. Then we have the cardioid pattern. It takes sound from the front, but doesn't take sound from right the back. So we have the SL75C here. Let's make a test.
Prova, 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 prova. Prova, 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 prova. Yeah.
The cardioid is good for vocal and speech. Who is next? We have the super cardioid pattern. What's the difference? So it's more sensitive to sound sources behind the microphone. It gives you more side rejection and a tighter pickup angle. So that's indicated when you want to record instruments in close proximity. Okay, super cardioid. Behringer B906.
C, 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 C. Prova, prova. Prova. Mic check, mic check, mic check, mic check, mic check, mic check. Mic check. Check, 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 check. Prova.
Bidirectional pattern. It picks up the same amount of audio from the front of the mic and the back of the mic. Like an 8, you know? Again with the Bigfoot. This is good for face-to-face interviews or podcasts.
Prova.
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 Yeah, here you go. Number three. Frequency response. It's the range of sound you can get from the mic, from its lowest to its highest frequency. A microphone with a wide frequency range that responds equally to all frequencies is said to have a flat frequency response. These mics capture a clean sound, so they are preferred for instruments such as pianos or acoustic guitars. Microphones that have instead a shaped frequency response, they show this peaks and drops at certain frequencies. It means that the mic frequency is shaped for a specific sound source. I hope you guys and girls found this video helpful. If you have any question, please write a comment in the section below. See you in the next video. Ciao!